Secretary of State Hohmann, Director Liebig, Mr. Dudak, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor and pleasure for me to welcome you all of you here in Berlin to this conference. And usually these welcome addresses have some problem because all are telling more or less the same. Today it's quite important that the Ministry and DLR are acting complementary. So you heard already some words in German. You could read some words in English. I will now give additional words in spoken English and in broken English and add this with pictures. But more or less it's the same contents, so you will have different perspectives of the same idea. Let's start with the basic idea of space technology. Why are we doing it and what are we doing? So starting with this, I think beyond all the ideas what is the value of space activities, we have always to accept that man is driven by curiosity. This is true for all the time being. This was true in the past. Columbus was one of the famous persons, but also some other persons who went up the Himalaya. There is no commercial value of that. However, man is doing it and is driven by curiosity. But in the field of Earth observation, we have a special target. We are looking to our tiny planet and we see the changes of this planet and learn how this planet is acting. Weather forecast is a very simple question we can solve by that. Climatic change is much more complicated. Disaster management. We have the aspects of forest fires, tsunamis, earthquakes, flooding and others. And of course land management, settlement management and civil security are aspects of Earth observation and as to be solved. If we are now looking to our other satellites, one was already mentioned, TerraSat X, this can be used also to investigate flooding and the consequences, especially for the disaster management. This is a picture of the city of Villahermosa in Mexico, and the blue areas are really the flooding. It's not only the question where is water, but the question is what changed at the area, and the blue one is the water due to the flooding. Another picture from Indonesia, the tsunami, and you see here before the tsunami and after it, and the change is big. It's not only a question for the TV to have pictures of the flooding, but it's also very important to give some guidance to the different associations and institutions for help at the location. But for all of this, we need satellites. And of course, it was mentioned, Envisat is a very important European satellite launched 6 years ago. But we are also playing here a national game with our national satellites like TerraSat X, which was launched last year and after just 5 days produced very nice images, radar images. We will have a launch of RapidEye hopefully this year and EnMAP in about 4 years. So there is a big variety also of national activities in Earth observation, and today we signed here, not we signed, but Astrium and ESA signed a contract for EarthCare, a satellite, a European satellite produced in Germany. And finally, the activity of GMES, Global Monitoring for Environment and Security, which is more than just a satellite program. It's an overall program to understand about the globe, to have different services for the help of different institutions. So I think this conference today is just in the core of Earth and Earth observation and space activities, and therefore we are very happy that we can play the role of a host of this conference, and therefore I welcome all of you again. Thank you very much.